the same hate that's caused wars from religion, gender to skin color, the complexion of your pigment, the same fight that led people to walkouts and sit-ins. It's human rights for everybody, there is no difference. Live on and be yourself. I don't know.
And I can't change, even if I tried, even if I wanted to.
Everyone else is more comfortable remaining voiceless rather than fighting for humans that have had their rights stolen. I might not be the same, but that's not important. No freedom till we're equal. Damn right I support it.
The work we are doing is very critical. It is life risk.
他是一个父亲，他竟然去伤害我的孩子。
I was told in non-certain terms that disgusting people like me, there was no place for them in the armed forces.
Aquí nos matan por simple hecho de decir, pues, sos culero, sos marimacha, pues te vamos a matar por deporte.
Nací biológicamente mujer, pero mi identidad es masculina. No puedo decir que tuve una infancia bonita, más cuando me nacieron los pechos. Yo le decía a mi mamá que me los cortara, que no los quería tener. Buscaba la forma de que alguien me viera, pues que no quería que me creciera eso, pero no, nadie me escuchó. Muchas veces lo grité, decía, yo soy un hombre igual que mis hermanos. En ese momento tal vez no me daba cuenta de que me autoidentificaba como un hombre transexual, ¿verdad? Pero el tiempo va haciendo que uno se descubra como persona. La verdad que vivir en Honduras como persona transexual, aparte de la violencia en la que estamos ya acostumbrados, pues para las personas transexuales es bastante difícil porque vemos 2, 3 personas muertas al mes de la comunidad transexual, de la comunidad LGTBI en general. Aquí nos matan por simple hecho de decir, pues sos culero, sos marimacha, pues te vamos a matar por deporte. Honduras es un país donde falta todo. Falta seguridad, falta educación. La justicia pues es bastante ciega. El culpable está libre y los inocentes están presos.
¿7个月多就会叫了? 他就哎，奶奶，他就说奶奶，他看到我就奶奶。啊，我现在跟我太太一起经营一个家庭，那在台湾算是比较少见的同志家庭，就是拥有小孩的家庭。你以前就还有那种文青 feel， 然后现在就是整个是妈妈，妈妈，亲爱的妈妈。
因为在台湾目前还是没有办法用依循法律的方式去做试管婴儿，同志朋友要做这些事情是必须要到国外。
我的确会担心孩子被欺负，可是我要让你知道，没有人可以因为你有两个同性别的母亲就可以伤害你。那他在未来面对到这些压力跟比较不友善的声音的时候，或许他一开始会很痛苦，可是他会比较有力量走出去。 我觉得最大的挑战是台湾没有反歧视法，这是一个很严重的事情。那有小朋友，有国中生，他是小男生，但他可能比较阴柔一点，然后就被同学嘲笑霸凌，说你是同志，你会得艾滋。那个小男生他从四楼跳下来，老师还写了一个很温馨的字条，说你很笨。 这就是歧视。你们再看一看，你们再看一看，是什么？我们是有血有泪的人，你们抗议的是不让我的孩子有家。恐同分子，我觉得是恐同分子，然后去举行了一些游行或者是抗议会场，然后他们要去抗议婚姻就应该要绑定在一男一女的这种游行。 然后我们就带着小孩，就我们那天回到家里，我在脸书上公开发文，那其中有一个爸爸，然后他就盗用了我的孩子的照片，他就写到说这是恶心的女同性恋生下来的可悲小孩，他用了我的孩子的照片，所以我就忍不住，真的超级生气的，他是一个父亲，他竟然去伤害我的孩子。
为什么不能想想看，如果今天是你的孩子被这样伤害，你站得住吗？你能够承受得住吗？凭什么我的孩子要被这样伤害？Bisexuality. I grow up, then I come to realize like I'm not attracted having a relationship with the girls, but I'm so much romantically, emotionally attracted with my fellow men. Yeah. Due to the security situation, now it's not welcome for me to identify myself openly. I would love to, but it will backlash to me. Either I'll be in higher risk to be attacked, abused, or even to be put in jail. No. I am a rights defender. We are defending those who are sexual minority. Our government doesn't recognize the LGBT peoples, and mostly is about religion. Muslim, they believe what has Quran said about these peoples. So the new government, the regional commissioner announced, I don't want to see this community in my cities. And if anyone have seen those people, like should come to me and allowed to arrest. So now people, they are afraid to come and look for the services. Some of them, they are even moved in town and live bush area where they feel that they are safe. We had clubs where it's free for any persons. Because gay people, the way they dance, it's totally different with the straight persons. So we had that place where gay, they can express themselves the way they want without anyone interfering or judging the way he or she dance. But after these changes, that club, they had been shut down. It's no longer there. So that's challenges.
Thank you.
I was in the Navy for just under 18 years. I joined up in 1976. I had a fantastic time. However, in my basic training, it became evident within a couple of weeks that they didn't accept gays. And if anybody was caught, they'd be kicked out immediately. It certainly came as a shock to me. Here they were telling me that I wasn't good enough, or not personally, but anybody of my, you know, nature. I've had a look through this for years, I haven't. Yeah, this is all the guys who I used to work with. Yeah, they were a good bunch of lads, they were, and girls. But I'm bisexual. I've always kept it to myself. I was aware of it from when I was about 10 years of age. It was just a gut feeling that I wasn't the same as everybody else. Well, I was living a lie, but I always made sure I never did anything illegal. I was very careful who I went out with. I was very careful what I said, because the slightest thing you say wrong, and you'd have the Special Investigation Branch shadowing you, reading your letters. But I was convinced that I could lead my life and play along with the game. It was just a trumped-up charge. What they said is that I'd got into bed with this guy and I'd touched the side of his thigh, and that's all there was to it. In the end, I was found not guilty of this charge, but like most charges, they always throw in a second one, which is conduct prejudicial to good order and naval discipline, and I was found guilty of this charge. Well, straight afterwards, they took me to a room, and an SA, that's a stores assistant, came in with a pair of scissors. I said, "Sorry, mate, I need this medal," and just cut it off my tunic. He left me with my Northern Ireland medal and my Falklands medal. But in 12 years, I'd had an unblemished history, and yet all that hard work I'd put in meant nothing.
Aquí nos sentimos vulnerables. Tengo un pasado lleno de bastante violencia, pero de una u otra manera pues me ha ayudado a salir adelante. Cuando tenía 15 años fui acosado, por decirlo así, por la persona que se dio cuenta de mi identidad. Muchas veces me prestó su ropa y me decía, ponete esta camisa, ponete este pantalón que te va a quedar bien. Él se hizo pasar por mi mejor amigo, pero después empezó a acosarme. Me violó en compañía de otras dos personas. Me abandonaron en una quebrada sin piedad. Me defendí hasta donde pude, pero ellos me dieron por muerto. No sé nadar y me quedé flotando en el agua así por mucho tiempo. Creo que fue un tiempo que completamente me desgarraron la vida. Los hombres trans son más invisibilizados que las mujeres. Creo que el último grupo en descubrirse, por decirse así, o darse a la luz, me sentía en un campo solo y yo decía, ¿será que hombres transexuales solo soy yo? ¿Y los demás dónde están? ¿Cómo hago? Yo tengo aproximadamente 6 años sin un trabajo formal. No existe en Honduras una ley de identidad de género que me garantice que yo pueda tener esa oportunidad de trabajo. La identidad representa un obstáculo. Una identidad en Honduras es esto. Es lo primero que un empleador me va a revisar. Entonces, ellos miran un nombre femenino y una cara masculina. Entonces, no concuerda a la hora de pedir un trabajo. La discriminación, entonces, aumenta. Entonces, en el momento que dicen, ah, es una persona con la comunidad LGTBI, entonces ya llega una gran desventaja y a que mi currículum termine en un basurero. Yo, bendito Dios, pues mi pareja me apoya de una u otra manera en todo lo que yo necesito, a diferencia de otras personas que no tienen nada, entonces se ven obligados. Muchos a vender drogas, otros a... pues se meten en grupos de maras. Eso es otra de las partes, de la forma en cómo se mueren muchas de las compañeras y compañeros de la comunidad trans. Pues yo salgo a las calles, platico con la problemática, con personas de la comunidad LGTBI. Creo que muchos jóvenes ahora pues se están matando por los problemas que pasan. El enseñarle a una persona que no está sola, pues le da esa motivación de seguir viviendo. ¿Tiene miedo a qué?
A burlas, porque estamos en un país donde por cualquier cosa se burla. De repente, en otros países es más abierto, es más bonito, es porque las leyes son diferentes. Son otro tipo de vida que algún día yo conocería, algún día.
Luis, ¿y nunca pensó en ejercer trabajo sexual?
Llegué un tiempo que sí.
¿Sí?
Sí. Lo iba a hacer, pero hubo una meta y dije, no. Muchos amigos he tenido de que me inducen a que vayamos. Y una desesperación, a veces uno como que sí lo quiere hacer.
Sí, va.
Me gustaría ser querido y querer y poder contar con alguien.
这个时候侍从说：“等等等等等等，还有一个公主要来了。我们来看看，有请马德莲公主，还有她的哥哥小李王子。”王子看到了她，突然有了一阵心动的感觉了。到底是为了谁心动呢？他觉得很爱彼此。国外、欧美已经非常多的性平的绘本，去让孩子们可以理解说，有些孩子就是来自于同志家庭。 在台湾这些书籍非常的匮乏，所以我现在在做的事情，我在推的故事的内容，我就是希望说可以让小朋友们理解每个家庭都一样。我们来看看他为了谁心动。天哪，多么棒的王子啊！他第一次有了心动的感觉，旁边的一切都变成了粉红爱心小泡泡。接着他们非常的相爱，他们举办了一个很特别的婚礼。 台湾的身份证是上面会写父跟母的名字。我女儿翻到我的身份证，她就问我上面是什么，我们就是就像讲故事一样讲给她听。哦，这是我的爸爸的名字，然后这是婆婆的名字，你的婆婆的名字。然后她就问说，那我以后的身份证也会有妈咪跟妈妈的名字吗？我就想了一下，我就觉得很沮丧，跟她讲哦，可能不会。 所以他就跟我说，我很想要我的身份证上有妈咪跟妈妈的名字，我就觉得还蛮感慨，就是我没有想过事情会是这样，我们以为我们自己组了一个家，事情就很简单的 move on。
OK， 然后试试看，他可以的。
他可以的。然后我们也一直努力的再去游说，去跟有能力改变法案的人，去跟他们讲述我们的故事、我们的存在。我们现在做这些事情的时候，并不是为了我们自己想要结婚。我觉得婚姻很烂，婚姻 suck， 超烂的。在亚洲结婚不是你跟你两个人结婚，是两家子结婚，哇，超可怕！我根本就不爱他爸妈，我爱我老婆，可是我不爱他爸妈。 可是因为小孩，我们才想要结婚，想要给他更好的保障。是我们真正的梦想是要成功的收养小孩。对我们来说，这只是一个过程。好，脱了，啊，脱掉了，啊，脱掉了耶！The day I was discharged, I went back home.
I'm sat in an empty house. I had no friends down there because all my friends were in the armed forces. So I had no one I could talk to. I felt so lonely and isolated, it was unbelievable. I had no money coming in. I had a mortgage hanging round my neck. And I didn't know which way to turn. You know, in the end, I resulted going into farmers' fields and nicking potatoes and cabbages. So it took its toll on me, and I ended up something like £15,000 in debt. And it took me up to 10 years to sort my life out. I appealed against it. At least I wanted my medal back and my badges and my rank. In the end, as a wider scope, because had they not discharged me, I'd have got a full pension. Now, given that they dismissed me, it meant that I had to wait a further 17 years before I got a reduced pension. I don't want compensation. All I want is what justly is mine. I've been fighting now for 25 years, since 1993. My way of thinking is until my very last breath. I'll fight them because it's a just cause, and I'm not going to give in to them. I will get the medal back, trust me. That or else I'll snuff it.
I've been going through a lot. It reached a point that my brother chased me out from the family. Then from that, I think I have potential thing to do for my community who are suffering like what I have suffered. I started looking what the LGBT means, what is human rights means, for me to be able to empower myself before I engaged fully in this movement. We empower the community to know their rights first, to understand. When someone come to me and arrest, I should ask first, who are you and why are you arresting me? To minimize that being abused, something like that. Police raided the offices with the accusation that we are promoting homosexuality. The word promotions is unidentified. Because for us, we don't see that we're doing promotion. We are not recruiting people to become a gay person. I explained to them, I'm not doing any illegal work. What I do is under our constitutions. Our government also has developed some document on how to work on this group because they are in HIV high risk prevalence. There is an confusion. On the program, they do work with this community, but on the policy, they are arresting this community.
Esta es una playa en Omoa. Nos gusta venir acá por la seguridad. No sentimos el miedo de que nos vayan a asaltar o que nos vayan a golpear o agredir por nuestra forma de cómo nos van a ver. Entonces yo aquí puedo bañar tranquilamente, puedo quitarme la ropa sin tener el miedo de que me vayan que me vaya a pasar algo. Pues la relación con mi pareja no es fácil, pero nos hemos acoplado, aunque para ella no ha sido nada fácil porque, como dije, ella es lesbiana, pero me dice, bueno, yo te amo y te amo tal cual, voy a hacer realidad tu sueño, pues. Compró mi primer testosterona en Guatemala, lo anduvimos guardando, la trajimos y para mí fue, creo que, el regalo más grande que he recibido en toda mi vida.
Yo conozco una persona y me enamoré de esa persona, la esencia de esa persona. Pero una vez hormonizada esa persona, cambió en todos los sentidos. Y yo tuve que adaptarme a eso. Yo lo adoro. En realidad, he aprendido a quererlo tal y como es. y creo yo que él también me ama y porque yo lo siento y espero que siempre sea así.
Por fin tengo algo que yo quiero, que me hace y es el regalo más grande que usted me ha dado porque para mí es un sueño hecho realidad. Realmente hoy sobrevivimos más que todo por amor. Porque hasta el sol de hoy es con la persona con la que yo me siento protegido. Todos los vacíos que tenía me los llena. Hoy me dio el regalo más grande de mi vida, que es esto que soy hoy.
Well, I've had several girlfriends and several boyfriends, if you can call them that, but none of them ever seemed to work. You know, I'd like nothing better than to be married, have a couple of kids jumping on top of me, you know, ripping my hair out of my head. You know, I'd love that, I would, but unfortunately, it's not to be. No, I can't explain it. It's not the people's fault who I've been with. It's my fault, because I cannot accept it. I know I am bisexual, but I don't know. It's very difficult. So rather than go with anybody else now, I've resigned myself. I'm going to be an old man with no lovers or anything like that, you know.
Mwah.
那我可以亲你一下吗？我觉得你现在世界无敌超级正。你也是世界，嗯啊。画的挺好。彩虹旗，但是因为木头。到了到了。妈妈今天很美，对不对，爸爸？嗯，你也很美啊，今天头发绑得很整齐。
我觉得今天可以来到这边，终于可以登记，其实很感动的事。谁要结婚了？喵。喵是谁？猫。猫一家。猫一家要结婚，小猫跟大猫还胖猫还有小大猫吗？我是小猫跟大猫跟大猫。大猫跟大猫还有小猫，三个人一起结婚吗？
是吗？我们要变一家人了，是不是？办婚礼就到这里了。嗨，家属。嗨，护照。喂，谢谢你。谢谢你。是我们的证书，那可以结婚前一定要可以拿出证书。法律上面。 你一定要合法的双亲，我的妈咪跟妈妈是合法结婚，我是合法结婚的孩子，我不是。他在法律上，对，他是法律上有保障的孩子，这是说得住。所以我觉得我们真的算很幸运，我们有对的政府，同志权利真的会很辛苦。那我会其实希望说，正在里面辛苦的人们可以知道。 或许你们现在真的正在痛苦中，可是不要放弃。The
work we are doing is very critical, and it is very sensitive, and it's very risk. It is life risk. We do it because it is our life. So, when you found out. You live in a life like no one wants you or no one recognizes you. That's not a proper way to live. I do hope the end of the day, people will understand the human right is not only for the straight persons. We all deserve to be treated equally, regardless of who I am loving with or of what I am doing on bed. As long as I'm a human being, I deserve to be respected, I deserve to be protected, I deserve to access health services, I deserve to be educated, I deserve to be employed. This movement has been there for a long years back. And for us, I think we're just in early stages in terms of movement building. So I very much hope that at the end of the day, our government will recognize us as a human being.
I don't know.
And I can't change.